And I often say, if you, for all of you, if you can find a choice that is different from sitting at a table having the conversation, make it. And here's why. First of all, we see this all the time. You know, so as artists, be creative and figure out something else that you... You know, I saw one of the most interesting doings the last Tuesday night's class, and I say this because I've been coaching 23 years, and it's seldom that I see something I've never seen before. And these two guys came in, and they did it. You can't do it in this scene, but they had one chair and another chair in front, and they had oars, and they were in the water, and they were paddling. It was precious. Oh, it was so cute. Precious. Isn't that great? Yeah. Of course, it fits in with the scene, what was going on. Believe it or not, I think you can take it further.
Beyond further?
Hey, I think you can be more of a charmer.
Okay.
Yes, because I feel like this is a sort of scene, and I give this note often. The things we do in class, for the most part, I try to make sure that they're really well written. And the downside of a really well written scene is that often, and it's not even a conscious thought, but actors really don't have to work as hard. Mm-hmm. You know, if something's a piece of shit, then we have to really get in there and figure out what can we do to just make this tolerable or performable, you know, just get through it. Mm-hmm. You see that more on auditions than in class. But I really think that it is so well written and the lines are so incredibly charming that an actor just feels like, well, I just say the lines and it's going to work. And it can work up to a point.
I feel like my character is tries to be a little bit more truthful and honest.
Well, this is what I'm looking for. I think you're more of a, you know, in terms of the archetypes, you're more of a spunky kid. You're more of a Tigger, and she is the Eeyore.
Okay.
You know, that's such a great dynamic, and really, you know, we see that dynamic. It's a, you know, I think purposely written in a lot of scenes, a lot of movies. But if you can incorporate it, oh my gosh, it gives you so much to hook into, you know, as an actor. So if you find yourself, you just want to have fun and you just killed it in class and you come out of there and there's your friend is like, oh God, her again. Okay, what's going on? Earth to LA, you know, and then you get to have some fun. Then a lot of your beats and actions are about, you know, just cheering her up. You become the court jester. Yeah, I made it up. Oh, that's a bunch of bullshit, you know. You're going to say anything to make her feel better, you know. And, there's a thing in screenwriting, and it's basically if you can't show it, don't tell it. You know, so a lot of, like, screenwriting teachers don't like voiceover narrations. However, that being said, there are some filmmakers who use it brilliantly. The Coen brothers in Raising Arizona, there's a ton of narration. Goodfellas. I think half real lines are voiceover narration, but it moves, and I think he can back it up because there's visually we see what's going on, and it's brilliant. But for the most part, you know, I had an actor years ago. Anytime he selected a monologue for himself to do, he would always pick a voiceover monologue. You know, we use your personalities, your essence, to navigate the scene. But on occasion, you're going to come across a character who is very different from you. Mm. And I think Daniel Plainview is very different from you. And again, in that he is ruthless. Mm-hmm. The wheels are just always turning. And he's probably, throughout this entire thing, what do you think he's thinking?
Dumb kid with oil in him, I want to take.
And I wonder if I should kill him after I have this conversation. Yeah. He's really got he doesn't have a conscience.
Yeah.
You know, he really doesn't. You know, there's that brutal scene in the bowling alley at the end. Mm-hmm. So I would love to, if you were an animal, what would you be?
Oh, well, probably a big old mean lion or something.
I think he's more subtle than that. I think he's a snake.
Oh, okay.
Let's set it up as if this is only like his second day on the job.
Oh, okay.
Okay, that's a really, really great tool to endow a lot of things as if it's the first time or it's just something new. Because the first time something new, they just have a more powerful energy behind them, okay? You're just more passionate about it.